Welcome. My name is Natasha Sherman, and I am your host. And my guest today is Mary McNerney, and she is the author of Earth Speaks Up. So Mary received her law degree from Georgetown University and had a career in corporate and international law in Boston and Prague until she was unexpectedly propelled into this entirely new direction of working together with the Earth and sharing Earth's voice through writing and experiential workshops. Mary has learned how to attune to Earth's voice and vibration and how to work with that. So welcome, Mary.
Well, thank you, Natasha. It's a pleasure to be here chatting with you and your listeners and having the opportunity to share.
Yes, I'm excited. And so it sounds like a bizarre journey because, you know, you start being an attorney, an international attorney, and then suddenly you're speaking for the Earth. Talk to us about that transition, how that came about.
That's a story I do like to share with people because it gives perspective on for all of us. I was writing this book, Earth Speaks Up, was not on my radar screen. As you said, I was a corporate attorney, pretty well ensconced in paperwork and drafting contracts and negotiations and just managing business logistics. Your usual, what is it, right brain, is that our logic side or left brain, whatever our logic, rational side is. Yeah. Then I was home from work one day. It was a weekend, and it was a lovely day outside. I was just enjoying the free time I would have away from all that pressure of work. And I was looking out the window and thinking, wondering what will I do for that day? Grab my husband and our dog, go out for a walk in the woods, or take my horse out for a ride. I was just thinking, what will I do with this day? And then I happened to say out loud to no one but myself, because I was the only one in the room, I said, what shall I do today? And then, Natasha, I heard clearly and distinctly, take dictation from the Earth. And I knew right away it was from the angelic realm. There was no one else in the room, but it was very clear, and an angelic message. And I was startled initially, and I just stood there thinking about it. It was a very profound idea, but I thought really meant for a more illustrious spiritual type or a nature guru. I'm a corporate lawyer. So I just put the idea in the back of my mind and pretty well forgot about it until about 6 months later, I heard the same thing, take dictation from the Earth. And so I, I don't know what to do. I'll give it a try. So I took a pen and paper in hand and went out and sat on the edge of the woods in our backyard, and just sat there. And then all of a sudden the word started coming, and it was this profound wisdom and depth and an experience unlike any I'd ever had. And it was hard initially for my pen and my hand and my mind to keep up with the words, with the dictation. And I continued doing this, though, over the ensuing months and years. And what came forth was this book. It was quite clear to me from the outset that I was being dictated a book. And it was from the voice of the Earth, the consciousness of the Earth. Our Earth is a conscious, sentient, and communicating being. And it was also supported by aimed from the angelic realm, individuals from the angelic realm who came across to me is very a group of very wise professors. That's the way it sounded to me, who came in support of the relationship between Earth and humanity, in trying to support and foster this relationship to help it move into the next level where we need to go in connecting with Earth.
Okay, so I'm going to interrupt you at this point, and I can imagine how startling that must have been. On the one hand, you talk about, you know, you're an attorney and you're using the logic side of your brain, but it occurs to me when you mentioned I knew it was from the angelic realm that you must have had some relationship to that already, some spiritual belief system, or was it brand new for you?
Well, no, I did have a spiritual belief system, as you say. Yeah, I was always aware that we're in a multidimensional world. It's not just our 3D human dimension. Because I was fortunate to grow up in a family that was very open-minded in that way, my parents were very open-minded, and we all were aware of the angelic presence and the consciousness of all life around us.
So I'm going to interrupt you here because I think that's really significant. So it's very easy for a lot of people who work just with the, and I think it is the right brain, but the logic realm to poo-poo this and go, another whack job. On the other hand, as you describe your family, it's kind of the way I perceive the world is anything is possible. I mean, the fact that we exist here on the planet, the fact that our body works the way it works, the fact that a plant, one little flower has so many characteristics and so many little intricate designs, that why would we not think that there's some consciousness to any of this? So I'm the only reason I'm saying this is to just kind of ask people to open up to the possibility and to listen from that perspective, like, anything is possible. So you talk about taking notes, and would you reread the notes? Would you just collect them? Did they feel purposeful, or were you just kind of, another day of dictation?
No, it was very purposeful. I would write the dictation. And initially it was hard for me to work at that level because our mind is not used to working. It's like a different frequency when we connect in with other dimensions in that way. So it was initially hard for my mind to work it that way. It takes a little practice. And then I would come when I would choose to make the time to go out and sit and take the dictation, then the next chapter of the book would come, and the next chapter of the book would come. And it was always amazing new information for me, and I would go back and read it later and process it and really fully understand it more. But as it was coming through, it was always amazing and profound information.
And would you share it with anybody? Did you talk to other people about it?
Oh, yeah. I shared it with everyone in my family, from a very large family, everyone in my family, and a few other people who are open-minded in this way. And people who read it were like, this is amazing. Everyone was like, wow. Mm-hmm. It opened their eyes to the fuller nature of what our world, what our planet is. And everyone who read it felt, this makes sense. It's just knowledge that we as humans have been disconnected from.
Yes. I just want to talk a little bit about it, because there's something you say in the book. We in our time hold on to the belief that Earth is merely a compilation of dirt and rock. That is our perception. But as past experience taught us, that is not necessarily the reality. So, you know, so people go along and, clearly our the way we're treating the planet at this point points to a level of unconsciousness, not relating to the Earth as a living, breathing entity. And so we continue to do damage and we continue to ignore. And so just from that point of view, how do you get people to listen and to actually reconsider? So we have climate deniers. I mean, you know, it seems almost impenetrable to present to them the idea that we're all part of the same thing.
Yeah. And I think it's everyone is at their own level and at their own place and in their journey in this world. And some people cannot relate to what you and I are discussing, Earth Speaks Up, or any of these more esoteric concepts. And that's okay. That's where they are. They're on their own journey. But other people do see this. Other people do resonate with it. And I think the important thing is to get the word out there that our planet is this living, conscious, communicating being who needs us to engage with her. And some people are going to resonate with that. And the more and more people who resonate with that, it has a ripple effect. And we turn our attention to the earth differently than we've been doing before. I mean, it's the same thing through humanity's been with through the ages. I mean, a few centuries ago, we were all quite sure the earth is flat. And that was reality. That was fact. Until explorers showed us otherwise. And our reality was the earth is the center of the universe until science showed us another truth. And we all believed that the earth revolved around the sun. That the sun revolved around the earth. That was fact.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Then we learned otherwise. So here we are now at this place right now learning, Earth is a communicating being, a living, conscious, communicating being. So here we are opening another door to our expanded knowledge of the Earth.
You know, I love the concept and on many levels. And for me, it occurs like, you know, if people immediately shut down around it, mm-hmm. It's like this idea of, the planet is our home. I mean, let's face it, it's our home. And we need the planet in order to survive. Without a functioning planet, we as humans, other entities may exist, but we as humans, you know, without food that comes from the earth, without an earth that is rich in the nutrients, without clean water, we'll die, we'll disappear. And so it's really, if you look at it, taking care of your home, and you go down to your apartment or your actual home, would you destroy or poison all the things in your home? So mm-hmm. I think just in terms of that concept, it might be more accessible to people. I think mm-hmm. it's hard for people to think about the earth as a living, breathing entity. But the concept is wonderful. And, you know, just you give some exercises. And I think I just read about this study it was a well-documented, many people involved around the planet about spending time in nature. Mm-hmm. And they came to the conclusion, this was like a hard number, that if you spent 2 hours a week in nature, they can measure the positive results in your immune system, in the way your emotional system. So just in terms of that alone, there's something when you're out there that you're picking up.
Just as you're saying, you're connecting with the earth's vibration. The earth has, as a living being, has a vibration, and when we're in nature, we feel it. When we get busy with our work and indoors and busy with TV or whatever, we separate ourselves from it, which is okay, but it's important to go back and connect and keep that connection going. And the more and more we become aware that Earth's vibration, it's like we see ourselves as these bodies, these physical bodies, but we know we're much more than that. We know we are body, mind, and spirit. And so too is everything around us. This tree is body, mind, and spirit. This horse is body, mind, and spirit. This planet Earth is body, mind, and spirit. We're all that same essence. And once we recognize that, then we're able to connect more deeply with who that being is, with who that tree is, with who this planet is. We recognize their consciousness, and we can attune to that and attune to that vibration. And as we attune to it, we can bring about a healing and receive healing by fostering the connection that is between these living beings.
You know, it's the thought, you know, it's stop killing the hand that feeds you. But
Right, exactly.
I don't know if you've heard of, this was decades ago, the book, The Secret Life of Plants.
Oh, yeah.
And they did studies where the plant knew if you were coming, you know, they measured where it knew if you were coming toward it to harm it, and where it could actually sense from its owner in another city something going on. And it all sounds bizarre, but it was measurable. Mm-hmm. And I think for us in the Western world, we feel like if we can measure it, you know, it must be believable. Yeah. And so for some people, that might be what they need to do. But let's take a look at what you can advise people, because you, in your book, you give exercises and simple exercises. And I know I've done some reading on earthing, you know, where you just make sure that you walk barefoot on the earth and to connect and get the energy of the earth. So what are some specific small things that people might even do just out of curiosity to see what the experience would be?
Well, in the book, as you said, they're not my exercises. Again, these were dictated and given to us, shared with us by the earth or the angelic realm, to guide us into a deeper connection with the earth. And it's amazing how simple it is. We in our society think everything has to be big and complex, complicated in order to do it or achieve something. But connecting to the earth is amazingly simple. We don't have to be outdoors to do it. You can connect and attune to the earth from wherever you are, in the top of a skyscraper, at work, because the earth's vibrational field is so huge. Her atmosphere is her vibrational field. And it's so enormous, we can attune to the earth from wherever we are. And there's simple exercises in the book that can take just 5 minutes to do, bringing our awareness into the earth. And then we're also, and once we do that, and it'll take a little bit, I wish I could guide you all through it now, but it'll take 5 or 10 minutes to get that going. But I urge you to pursue it in the book. Because once we attune to the earth and start working with the earth in this way, we're also given exercises on how to do healing together with the earth on the energetic level. Once we start doing this, it opens up amazing new possibilities for us to work together with the earth co-creatively to foster healing for the planet and for ourselves, because we're not separate. As you said, Natasha, she is the hand that feeds us. And so when we support the earth and do these small meditations, small exercises to work on the energetic level with earth, that's where we create change. And that's where we can approach this climate change, global warming concern from a whole different angle. We can begin working on the energetic level together with earth to support healing and help clear the earth of these toxins and energetic negative vibrations that have built up and saturate her well-being. So when we start working on the energetic level, that's where change is created, instead of waiting till problems arise on the physical level. So yeah, you were ahead of question.
Yeah, no, I that's quite profound. So we can change on the energetic level. Mm-hmm. So say a little bit more about that, because, you know, what would we be doing to do that?
And that's where this book comes in, and these simple exercises, simple meditations, it guides us in beginning to do healing work on the conscious energetic level. We as humans look at everything in the physical realm, the 3D realm, but underneath our three-dimensional world is the energetic realm of creation, that creative force, that creative vibration that then brings forth the physical. So this book teaches us how to connect to that energetic level and work with it in a simple way. And once we are working on that level, it has a ripple effect. It moves beyond us, because energy is fluid, and the energetic level is sort of amorphous. It moves out from us, whereas the physical world is, we're more constrained. And when we wait to do surgery on the physical body, it's more complicated than if we start healing and clearing our bodies energetically of toxins or through maybe things like Reiki or acupuncture or Jinshin Jitsu or any of those things that work on the energetic level. That's in a way we're using those principles to then to work with Earth on the energetic level. And it sounds a little complicated now when I try and synopsize it for you, but the very simple exercises in the book give us specific guidance on how do we do this. And it's far simpler than we as humanity have recognized.
You know, I think you're bringing in the whole concept of working at an energetic level, because that idea has become more mainstream. So Reiki, energy healing, all of those things that people are going, oh, okay. So if you can extrapolate from that into, we could even heal the earth, and yes, there are physical actions that would be useful, but we can heal the earth energetically. And let's face it, absolutely everything is energy.
Yes, the foundation of everything is energy. And that's the exciting part of this, Natasha, which I feel is really compelling, because we all see on the news the climate change issues and people around the world going out and protesting and marching and demanding climate justice, attention to climate change, and demanding and protesting that somebody do something. Government, get out there and do something, corporations, science, do something about climate change. And we put our energy into protesting and demanding that because we feel, I'm just a sole individual. What can I do? There's nothing I can do. I recycle, I try to conserve energy, but there's nothing more I can do. So except protest and demand that somebody else do something, big government do something. But the wonderful thing is, there is something we as individuals can do, and this is where we create change. This is the new dynamic for we as humanity to recognize. When we each step into recognizing we have this innate power and this innate capability to attune to Earth and work co-creatively with Earth and create on the energetic level. Once we start learning to work and connect on the energetic level, we can bring about change. And this is where we as individuals can step into our own abilities and our own powers. Instead of just demanding somebody else do something, we can look at ourselves and, oh, I have the ability to bring healing for this planet.
Yeah, and I think we live at a time where we mostly do feel powerless, and the problems are so overwhelming. And I think there's a place for protesting. I think there's a place for speaking up and all of that. But I think it's also very encouraging and even exciting to think that we actually have the power just to energetically shift something. And I think if you bring it down to a daily level, if you walk into a room and energetically you're carrying a lot of anger, everyone can relate to this. We pick that up immediately. You walk into a room and you're just oozing love and compassion, whatever, people can relate to that and pick up on that. So if you can do it in a small situation, you know, energy, there's no stopping energy, it just keeps going. So it's a way for people to wrap their minds around it. I have two other questions to ask you. Do you still practice the law?
No, Natasha, I've been pulled in this other direction, and I feel this is far more important. Working with the earth in this way is far more important. And it was kind of a gradual transition, but I got more and more. So I had to devote my energy to working with the earth in this way and just sharing this with other people.
And what has, if you go out and speak in public, I know, it's like you go into your family that loves you, so you're preaching to the choir, they're already supportive of you. Do you have people challenging you and going, are you nuts?
Well, you know, not so much, and I'm sure there are those people out there, but the people that are drawn to me and drawn to doing this work together with me and with others in the same page, we're already on the same page. So I'm not encountering so many people that think it's bizarre, but they're out there, and that's okay. It's
yes, not, absolutely.
I don't feel, hey, my ego's not that fragile. If people think it's crazy, that's okay. That's where they are. But there's other people who realize this is new, this is important, and this is something to be looked at and experienced and recognize, oh, I have the opportunity to begin to work with the earth in a new way. And that can be really exciting for a good number of people. Yeah, and I think this is where our society is moving, because this climate, where the climate change situation is now, Earth can't do it herself anymore. We have brought her so out of balance that she can't bring about her healing herself. And that's why we as humans have been given this guidance that's through me and through this book and other people too. It's like, oh, here's a new way for us to view the earth and begin to work with the earth. And it's a really exciting opportunity to be able to step in to a new relationship, with a fuller relationship with earth.
Yeah. So actually, that's a great place to end, because we are at the end of our time. But I want to thank you for being my guest. And it is exciting. And I do invite people to check it out, if even a little bit of it resonates. Yeah. And again, you know, it's like, well, let me check this out. Let me try it and see what my experience is. Yeah. So I encourage people to connect with you, connect with your book, your website, and even get in touch with you.
And the exciting thing, Natasha, is that it's not just about helping Earth and attuning Earth's way. It's about, it helps us, each of us, to recognize we each have this innate capability.
Yes.
To work in this way.
That's powerful.
I was a corporate lawyer. I was no special illustrious spiritual type. I said,
right.
We're all capable of this. And it's empowering and exciting for all of us to step into this new opportunity.
Absolutely. So thank you.
Well, thank you, Natasha. It's been a pleasure.
My name is Natasha Sherman. Thank you for joining us.